Hello and thanks for tuning in. If you're new to the channel, please hit the subscribe button. If you're returning, thanks, I really appreciate it. Today we're going to talk about the Harbor Freight solar panels. If you've been following a couple of my other videos, this is about 4 or 5 years into it and I found two panels that were bad. And they have little LED indicators that let you know they're producing power. Two of them did not have an LED indicator on, so I assumed two of them were bad. So the very first thing you want to do when checking these things is come over and get you a multimeter. Set it to DC, and you're going to see this one is actually going to be working. So you have 22 volts coming out. And, you know, it's shady out right now, it's not too bad. These things will produce voltage in very little light. But as you can see, the LED is not on. So I'm going to have to look into maybe getting another LED in there. This one, you know, happens to be working, so I'm not going to do anything with it. But I'm going to flip it over and show you what else can fail in here so you can repair it. Okay, on the back of the panel, it's very simple. On the top where the power cord exits, you have about 8 screws. And they're going to be two right there, the two recessed ones. And then there's one self-tapping screw there. So the self-tapper goes right there. That self-tapper goes in that very first hole. These little holes get these tiny machine screws. Those tiny ones. And they go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You have 6 of the tiny screws and 2 of the big self-tappers that go right in the bottom and anchor the plastic to the metal. Once you remove that, you want to take a little hammer, and I got a little brass and plastic hammer somewhere. I don't know what I did with it. Oh, here it is. A little brass and plastic hammer, and you're just going to tap basically on this side. You just tap on these edges here. And this thing will slowly come up and then pop off. Then you're left with basically two spots. Power on the ground. So they like to break right around here. There's a solder tab in there. And it goes up underneath the plastic there and it solders to a little ribbon cable there. There's one there and there's one underneath here. It's under RTV. They like to commonly break there. So if that happens, all you're going to do is re-solder it to that little ribbon. Then in here you would have a diode and a resistor. I haven't seen those things burn out. It's been 5 years. It's, like I said, commonly the wires just break. So you'd look in there just for any... there's one resistor and one diode. See if they're burnt. You can replace them if they are, but like I said, I haven't seen any on any of my panels. Just broken wires. So I hope this helps somebody out. Your Harbor Freight panels are good. They can produce power without the blue light on, as you can see, and they do break commonly inside. So thanks for watching. Please subscribe.